I am really happy to announce that I release a Sky package through the Luminar Marketplace. So if you go to the Luminar Marketplace and you go to Skies, you can find here the blue Cloudy Skies package. It contains 25 beautiful cloudy skies and it is perfect for photographs like the one here in the top left, but also photos like this and this. If you want to replace the sky, it is perfect. So if you have a boring blue sky, this Sky package is the right package to buy. To show a little bit more about the type of clouds you can expect, this is the cloud package. So I will show you a few of them. As you can see, there is a lot of variety. And in Luminar itself, in the default skies, you can already find some cloudy skies you can use, but you don't want to use the same sky for every photograph, of course. So that's why it's so important to have a good database of cloudy skies. So in this tutorial, I will show you how to use the AI sky replacement filter in Luminar. And in general, that works pretty well, but sometimes when you replace a sky, it also gives problems. And that's where I want to focus on, because the easy sky replacements, everyone can do it, but the more problematic things like photos like this with all the lines, it is not really easy to use a new sky in a photograph like this. So let's go to the edit module and to the AI sky replacement filter. I will select a sky and just pick a random one. Let's see if this one is nice for this photograph. I think that works pretty well. And when you look at a photo like this, the first thought you maybe get is, ah, that works pretty nice. Even here, the lines are still visible. But I really recommend you, when you replace a sky, to zoom in the photo to see if it really works out, because sometimes small mistakes are visible and that's something you have to repair. So also in this photograph, as you can see here in between all the lines, it works well, but here with this line you can see some little bright spots, and that is something that is just a mistake by the filter. So the filter works pretty well in a lot of situations, but as you can see, sometimes it makes a small mistake. So in general, what I do, and the best thing to do first in the AI sky replacement, when you go to advanced settings, you have the close gaps. And close gaps, if you put it, well, the default value is 10, but if you put it more to the right, it's gonna adjust the mask it created. And well, as you can see, that already helped a lot. Actually, the problem is already gone by using close gaps. So close gaps is really powerful in solving issues with sky replacement. So let's check it in a few other places before I move on to another photograph. Seems like it works pretty well here also. So especially with a lot of details and things that cover the sky, be careful. Let's go to another photograph and see how well the sky replacement works. So even for photographs like this, there is a blue sky, there are some clouds, but the clouds are not really spectacular. So also for a photograph like this, it can be interesting to replace the sky. So let's select the sky. And one thing to take into account also, well, as you can see here, there's a little mistake here in the building, and that's because there is a lot of blue in the Freedom Tower also. So basically the selection, the automated selection of the sky created by the software made a little mistake, and that's understandable because there's a lot of blue in the Freedom Tower also. So we are going to repair that. Another thing I want to recover or to improve in this photograph is the water, because, well, the water is never blue here, but now there is not a good match between the sky and the water, because in general, the sky reflects in the water. That doesn't make it blue right away, but it makes it a little bit more blue than it is right now. Now there is not a good balance, I think. So let's check if we can solve this issue first here in the Freedom Tower in the top. The closed gaps in general doesn't work for issues like this because it's not really a gap. It's more like the color of the tower is too similar. Oh, it actually does help a little bit. In general, it's not the best thing to do or not the best option you have, but it already helps quite a lot. So let's see if we can improve it even better. In general, what I use is Sky Global. That can also really help to solve issues. So Sky Global and also the close gaps in general are your best friends to make the sky replacement even better. If that doesn't help, and I think that's going to be the case in this photograph, there is one last solution. So as you can see, there's still a part missing. Well, actually, this is helping. Okay, the close gaps does work in this this case, so that's really nice. If the close gaps and Sky Global are not solving the issue, the last thing you can do is to, well, let's make the problem visible again. The last thing you can do is you can go to Edit Mask, you go to the brush, and you are going to erase the sky from the tower. So make sure the brush is in erase, opacity 100, size, well, you can change the size depending on how large your subject is. Softness, I always use a high percentage of softness to make sure that you don't get really hard edges. Although for a building like this, there is a hard edge between the building and the sky itself. It can work, but I just put it a little bit lower, not too low. And then the trick is zoom in a lot, because if you don't zoom in a lot, as you can see, I'm almost in pixel level right now. So what I do now, basically I erase the part and you can get back the original tower. So you have to be careful here, especially in the border. But that's why I tell you to zoom in really close so you can make this selection or to erase it in a very accurate way. If you go too far like this, if you make a mistake, just go to paint and then you paint in the sky again. Well, this is a little bit of a battle sometimes to make it really look perfect. Sometimes you really have to lower the softness even more to make sure it is perfect, but I think you get the point how to make it even look better. You don't have to do the whole tower. You can do the whole tower, but in general you only have to do the part that is really problematic. So now you can see a little bit of a difference in color. So in this case, what I would do is I will erase a little bit bigger part of the selection to make it look more natural. So make sure, like, until this level of the building you erase everything, then I make it softer, the edge of the brush, to make sure it blends in a nice way with the rest of the building. I think it already blends in pretty well. So this is really the last solution you can apply if you have some problems with the sky replacements. All right. If you have skies like this, you have to take into account one important thing. Most skies are are having depth. So if you look at this sky, for example, this cloud is big and they're getting smaller when you get closer to the horizon. When you have a photo like this, this photo is taken with the camera pointed up to the sky, so your perspective to the clouds is different. Of course, you can replace the sky in a photograph like this, but it doesn't look natural all the time because the clouds in the top will look bigger than the clouds over here. So you have to be careful with that. This sky, for example, is perfect if you have an horizon here at the bottom of your photograph, but in this photo there is no horizon. The horizon is not over here, so it looks a little bit weird. So that's one important thing to take into account. Let's go back to the previous photo because I promise you to show you something else. I'm gonna remove the brush and I'm gonna use close gaps to solve the issue now. And as I told you, I want to bring a little bit more blue to the water to make it look more natural. The way you're doing that is, well, you can do it in different ways. So I want to close the gaps. Well, it looks actually pretty nice already. So if you want to make this a little bit more blue, there are different ways by doing that. In this case, I want to go to Pro. I just put the sky global a little bit lower because, as you could see, the clouds are a little bit visible in the rest of the buildings. So now I don't have to remove that by hand. So I go to Pro and I go to the adjustable gradient. And the nice thing about adjustable gradient is that you can add some cool colors to the bottom. And in this case, the orientation is by default in the middle. I want to lower that a little bit because I like the warm tones in the buildings. So I lower it. So most of the cool tones, the cooler tones, are applied in the water. So let's adjust it a little bit more. And I think this makes a good change. It looks much better than without. So I think that's another nice way of solving the color problem you get after a sky replacement. So not only replace the sky and think you're done, also check the rest of the photograph to see if the colors are matching with the sky. And if not, try to change it. And in this case, because there is a nice horizontal line, I can apply the adjustable gradient in a pretty easy way. So that's what I wanted to show you in this video. If you have some other problems with sky replacements, please leave a comment below. And also let me know if you bought the sky replacement package from the Luminar marketplace. And I'm really curious what you think about it and if that's going to help you by creating more variety in your sky replacements. Thank you for watching and see you next time. In our website, you can download a free cheat sheet about the Luminar keyboard shortcuts. So if you want to learn more shortcuts on the keyboard in a very fast way for Windows or for Mac, go to our website rosterphoto.com and in the menu go to Giveaways, Free Luminar Shortcuts Cheat Sheet, and you end up in this page where you can download it right away.